Welcome to the 2016 Memorial Day services, sponsored by the Town of Davie and the Scoutmasters Campery Committee of the Boy Scouts of America South Florida Council. The colors will be presented today by the Civil Air Patrol Pines Miramar Composite Squadron No. 286 under the command of Chief Master Sergeant Kane. Hand salute. Please join us in singing the national anthem. Please remain standing. Eagle Scout Jerry Hall from Crew 815 will now lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
All Scouts in uniform, Scout salute. Hollow this hand over heart, please. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Two.
Thank you.
Thank you to the Civil Air Patrol for presenting our colors this morning. You may be seated.
We now have a very special occasion to
take over the next few moments. Please welcome from Broward Sheriff's Office, Ron Lowther.
First, I'd like to thank the Boy Scouts for having us here today to recognize four World War II veterans with a special award, the Order of the St. George. I have a little story about a veteran I interviewed in Chicago by the name of Arthur Abrahamson, and on his 96th birthday, he received the Order of the St. George Medallion for his leadership and bravery as a tank commander. Here is part of the transcript from a citation he received. Arthur Abrahamson, 1st Lieutenant Cavalry, Headquarters Company 756 Tank Battalion, for valorous conduct in action against the enemy on April 29, 1945 at 1700 hours in the vicinity of Grafelfing, Germany, 1st Lieutenant Abrahamson, platoon leader, knowing the enemy was heavily armed, attacked the enemy at close range with his tank. He moved forward amid small arms machine gun and Panzerfaust fire and stopped to fire at the enemy, killing 15 to 20 of them, knocking out two machine gun nests and capturing 200 Germans and a battalion of Hungarians. The moral to this story is that Art was a Boy Scout. Actually, he stated to me in a very proud way of his years of being in the Scouts and going to scouting camp, and making it a point to tell me he earned the rank of Eagle Scout. This story is just a reminder to the Boy Scouts here and also the Girl Scouts, because I think it matters for them too. Of the service to your community and to your country, and what you learn in the Scouts could have an impact on the rest of your life. I would now like to introduce U.S. Army Major John Bender and recognize his wife Laura and their girls Grace, Audrey, and Rachel, who are here with us today. Major Bender is an Army and Cavalry officer currently stationed at U.S. Southern Command and a recipient of the Order of the St. George.
Thanks, Ron. It is my honor to be here on this Memorial Day to recognize these veterans with the Order of St. George Bronze Medallion. Today, we honor veterans and all those who paid the ultimate sacrifice in defense of our nation. The Order of St. George is an award given to those deserving cavalry and armor leaders by the U.S. Cavalry and Armor Association. The Cavalry and Armor Association was established in 1885, and since then, its mission has been to disseminate knowledge of the military art and sciences with special attention to mounted maneuver warfare, to promote professional development of its members, to preserve and foster the spirit, the traditions, and the solidarity of cavalry and armor and the U.S. Army and the United States Marine Corps. Any soldiers or veterans who may have previously been awarded the Order of St. George can come forward to the stage now. I think I might be the only one today until we recognize these men. All right. These warriors have been called to join the knighthood of the Honorable Order of St. George. St. George was born around 280 AD in Cappadocia region of Greece, where he was known as the Nestor of Cappadocia and was a member of the Roman Emperor's Mounted Guard. In 303 AD, the Emperor issued a decree to destroy all Christian churches and sacred writings, which outlawing the Christian faith. The Nestor, a recent convert to the faith, tore down the written order and stood against the emperor. For this act of bravery and defiance, he was imprisoned, tortured, and finally executed. After word of his sacrifice spread, early Christians changed Nestor's name to St. George, a saint that would symbolize bravery and dedication to faith and decency. Later, in the 12th century and more than 1,000 years after his execution, the citizens of a small Italian village claimed that they had seen him appear suddenly in the mist to slay a fierce dragon that had been tormenting them. The heroic image of St. George defeating the dragon symbolizes the gallantry and bravery of the mounted warriors and the ultimate victory of good over evil. Throughout history, warriors of many nations have related accounts of St. George appearing on the battlefields to help them in their righteousness to achieve victory. St. George is unique among all saints that he is the only one portrayed fighting mounted. His name has been linked to famous battles, military orders, and cavalry forces around the world. In fact, to this day, the Red Cross of St. George is the main element of the national colors of Great Britain, the Union Jack flag. In 1986, the United States Cavalry and Armor Association established the Honorable Order of St. George to recognize the very best tankers and cavalrymen among its members. Bugler, summon the mounted rider. To all here present, know ye that Mort Callan, Jean Palumbo, Edward Collins, and Daniel Lowenthal have been recognized for their long and honorable service to armor and cavalry, are hereby admitted into the Distinguished Knight in Order of St. George, Bronze Medallion.
Staff Sergeant Mort Callan is one of the last of the mounted cavalry from World War II, and a true cowboy. After boot camp at Fort Riley, Mort rode in the military rodeo circuit put together by General Strong to entertain the troops at a number of forts and bases. Mort was a trick rider and rode Broncos. When the war was ramping up, the 112th Cavalry was called to action, and Mort was sent to New Guinea with the 1st Squadron. Horses were shipped in from Australia for the use of the cavalry, but weather conditions were so harsh the horses had to be disbanded due to hoof rot to the horses from standing in constant water and the dangers of shrapnel and close quarters combat in the jungle. Now the 112th had to go on foot to fight the enemy using the cavalry fighting tactics learned on horseback. This way of fighting is what set them apart from the infantry and the Marines. While in New Guinea, as reinforcements to this 32nd Infantry Division, the 112th Cavalry engaged in close combat, successfully defending the Drenyamour line. For 15 days, they could only be resupplied by air. During this time, Mort's company was pinned down in foxhole for days, flooded by rain. With a wounded BAR man at his side, Mort took the Browning automatic rifle and was able to fend off the Japanese attacks while his fellow troopers were able to escape. For his actions, Mort earned the Bronze Star. On a scout mission in Finch Haven, New Britain, Mort had mountaintop observation of a Japanese airstrip. He would radio back every time Japanese planes took off so the Army Air Corps could intercept them. The 112th Cavalry was a special breed, and Mort was one of the finest, and to this day, still a true cowboy.
Thank you.
Corporal Gene Palumbo. Before being drafted in the Army, Corporal Gene Palumbo was a professional roller skater and entertainer. After his training at Fort Knox as a tanker, he instead was commanded to perform his roller skating routine for the troops with the USO. When his tank unit was ready to disembark, he snuck away, joining the other tankers boarding the ship on their journey into combat. Gene arrived in Oran, North Africa, where the 756 Tank Battalion was training for the invasion of Salerno, Italy. His position was that of a loader on a newly delivered Sherman tank. While in Italy and crossing the Rapido River, his platoon had retreated under fire. Gene helped two fellow tankers swim back across the river to safety, but unfortunately the current took one of the tankers away who could not swim. During the Battle of Cassino, Gene's company made numerous assaults, expending all their ammunition and continued rearming the tanks 4 to 5 times a day. When Gene's tank was hit during one of their missions, the crew escaped, and upon returning to the command post, they were immediately reassigned to another tank. Even with Gene being wounded from shrapnel in his arm, he still continued to fight for days on end. One day, while running a recon mission, Gene and an infantryman were taking two German prisoners back to the command post for interrogation. Gene drove the Jeep so fast through the forest in the dark of night, it scared the Germans so much that they cooperated for the interrogators. They begged their captors never to have to ride with Gene again. In Gene's journey to the end of the war, he made a difference with the 756 Tank Battalion. Gene, come on up for your award. Sergeant Edward Collins from New York went into the Army and trained as a tank mechanic, but later became a crew member on a Sherman tank. He was in the 3rd Army, 4th Armored Division. Edward discovered at the last moment while his group was preparing for the invasion of Normandy that his months of armor training would not be put to use on D-Day. Instead, his sergeant gave him a gun and said, "Here, you'll be using this instead." What most people don't know is that the Allies had too many aircraft and armor personnel, but did not have enough infantrymen to do a proper job. When Edward's company of the specially designed amphibious duplex drive Sherman tanks deployed, they all sank in rough seas. All the men he would have been with all drowned. Arriving on the third wave at D-Day with the infantry, he survived the onslaught of enemy fire. In the reorganization before the March on Berlin, Edward was reunited with the 4th Armored Division and fought on as a gunner with his Sherman tank. The last-minute switch saved his life and enabled him to fight in the Battle of the Bulge in the Ardennes, Central Europe, and the Rhineland with many tank kills and devastation to the enemy. When he went back to visit the beaches of Normandy a few years ago, he walked into the water with his shoes on to see if it was as cold as it was when he landed 69 years prior. Edward's son, Ed Collins, is here to receive the Order of the St. George Bronze Medal on his behalf. Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Lowenthal, after graduating from Rutgers University and active in the ROTC program, Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Lowenthal entered the Army January 1942. Once overseas, he helped train French troops on M10 tanks in North Africa. Dan was transferred to the 894 Tank Destroyer Battalion, where he served as platoon leader in Company A. First Lieutenant Lowenthal was in command of a platoon of tank destroyers supporting an infantry attack near Lanuvio, Italy. Heavy artillery fire, mortars, machine guns, and small arms fire stopped their advance. He continued to encourage and assist his crews while directing fire on the enemy. The next day, they were able to knock out 4 machine gun posts and repulse 2 counterattacks. A third attack threatened to overrun the infantry positions, but even though he had been severely burned from a direct hit on his tank destroyer, Dan moved his platoon into position and placed such heavy and effective fire on the enemy that the Germans were forced to withdraw. For his action, Dan was awarded the Silver Star in Gallantry in Action and promoted to captain. To his credit, Dan fought in Tunisia, Rome, Arno, Northern Italy, and the Po Valley campaigns. After leaving active service, Dan Lowenthal continued to serve in the Army Reserves, earning promotions to Lieutenant Colonel. Dan Lowenthal's daughter, Leslie Lowenthal, is here to receive the Order of the St. George Bronze Medallion on his behalf.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here. This concludes the Order of St. George portion of the ceremony.